Welcome to another week of Therapy on Thursday. I am Minister Dre with another therapy session entitled, I'm Rebuilding It, A Better Way. On a recent trip to New York to celebrate my grandmother's 95th birthday, we took the opportunity to do some sightseeing. I grew up in New York, but I enjoyed just being a tourist. One of the places that we laid our eyes on was the rebuilt World Trade Center Tower. The Ground Zero experience was exceptionally shocking and extremely sad at the same time. To be standing in the same area where two planes collided into each building, causing them to collapse, killing almost 3,000 people, was a surreal moment. Looking up into the skyscraper and being reminded about the stories of those who decided to jump out of the window, hoping that maybe they would survive, that was very heartbreaking. Who feels like trying again after suffering a tragedy of any type, but especially one like this? But the truth is that the impact of any loss will influence your motivation to rebuild. After the 9/11 attacks, Larry Silverstein, the developer of the World Trade Center towers, had to ask his wife whether he should rebuild or not. His decision to rebuild resulted in a new and improved structure that is now able to withstand any attack. And the rebuilding made a clear statement to every hater saying, you may not have knocked us down, but we don't stay down. Hashtag New York resilience. And that's the motivation for this message, that it takes resilience to rebuild. Come on, tell yourself, I bounce back. Ezekiel finds himself in the Valley of Dry Bones, where it's his time to rebuild. In chapter 37, Ezekiel said, God led me back and forth among the ruins and asked me, Son of man, can these bones live? I said, Sovereign Lord, you alone know. Then he said to me, prophesy to these bones and say to them, this is what the Sovereign Lord says to these bones. I will make breath enter you and you will come to life. Wow. In other words, God told Ezekiel, we about to rebuild. Listen, we all have areas in our lives that resemble a heap of ruins. Ruined relationships, business endeavors that have dried out our bank account, deferred dreams that have dehydrated our enthusiasm. Now, don't get me wrong. There are some failures and some folks that have ransacked your life so bad, they are meant to be left in the ruins under file 13. But if God has had you walking back and forth amongst some dry bones that you thought were dead, asking you, can they live? God is not looking for you to react to it. God is looking for you to rebuild it. After he saw the heap of ruins, which used to be the towers, the first thing Larry Silverstein did was to ask his wife, should he rebuild? As saints, the first step in your rebuilding process is to take it to the Lord in prayer. Ezekiel told God in verse 3, Sovereign Lord, only you know if these bones can live. God, only you know if this problem can be resolved, if this relationship can be repaired, if this should be rebuilt. Somebody tell the Lord, only you know. Whatever it is that you're rebuilding, once God releases you, you have to rebuild it in a better way. Mark 9:17 says, no one puts new wine in old wineskins, for the old skins will burst from the pressure, spilling the wine and ruining the skins. Don't put pressure on the project. Listen, insanity is doing something the same way and expecting different results. If you want to be a better manager, then you have to build a better strategy, build a better team. If you want to have a better marriage, you have to become a better communicator. This pandemic has proven that the rebuilding process will be ruined trying to do things the old way. Pastor has been saying that when we come back together, we should be strong people coming back into a safe building, able to withstand attacks. Come on, tell yourself, I'm new and improved. So on this Soul Care Thursday, here are my two therapy ways to rebuild a new and improved structure. Come on, tell yourself, I'm rebuilding it a better way. First, you must fireproof your foundation. God told Ezekiel in verse 4, prophesy to these bones and say to them, dry bones, hear the word of the Lord. Fireproofing your foundation doesn't mean that the fire won't come at you. Fireproofing your foundation means that the fire won't consume you. Ask King Nebuchadnezzar. He couldn't see the consuming fire in the furnace because he was so focused on the fourth man in the fire that freed the three Hebrew boys. My God. Isaiah 43:2 says, when you walk through the blaze, the fire will not burn you. I praise God that the fiery blaze of my upbringing didn't consume me. I could have easily let the problems of rejection and resentment that I faced when I was growing up in my family ruin the way I regard family for my future generations. But I am building something new and improved, and I choose to fireproof my foundation by framing it on the Word of God. Come on, tell yourself, I'm standing on the word of God. God told Ezekiel to prophesy my word over it. When Satan prompts me to hold a grudge in my family, I prophesy Ephesians 4:32 that says, forgive each other as Christ has forgiven you. When Satan tries to divide us, I prophesy Colossians 3:14. Above all, clothe yourselves with love, which binds us all together in perfect harmony. I won't harm my husband with my words because Ephesians 5:33 tells me to honor him. I prophesy the word of God and promote unity. I promote understanding and communication and compromise over the foundation of my family, making it fireproof. I'm rebuilding it a better way, and I choose not to let my desire for a better family dry up and die. Come on, somebody shout, these bones shall live. So you must first fireproof your foundation, and finally, you must soundproof your structure. God told Ezekiel in verse 4 to prophesy to the bones and tell them to hear the word of the Lord. Now, some of us would have been talking about him behind his back if we saw him talking to some dry bones, saying Ezekiel's elevator don't go all the way to the top. But how many of you know that God will sometimes ask you to do things most people won't understand? 1 Corinthians 1:27 says, but God hath chosen the foolish things of the world to confound the wise. Larry Silverstein stated that he faced a lot of flack when he decided to rebuild the tower, but he had to tune out the negative talk and push aside people's perspectives to stay focused on the purpose. Whatever God is telling you to rebuild, you have to soundproof your structure by only listening and being led by the Lord. Don't let outside influences, especially negative ones, ruin your plans to rebuild. Now, don't get me wrong again. Taking into consideration the opinions of others is fine, but when it's all said and done, God should have the final say. Ezekiel said in verse 7, so I prophesied as I was commanded. And as I was prophesying, my God, there was a noise, a rattling sound, and the bones came together, bone to bone. Come on, tell yourself, I hear the chains falling. Because you listened to the Lord and stepped out on faith, I see the bones coming together on that business plan. I hear the rattling sound in that relationship. Stuff is starting to come together for you. Stop crying and stop prophesying, and you will see it come to life. Come on, put a praise and a prophecy on it. Soundproof your structure. Don't let folks convince you to call off the construction. Keep recreating yourself. Become the best version of yourself. Keep redeveloping your dreams. Keep rebuilding your family. Come on, tell yourself, the ruins can't make me run away. God asked Ezekiel, can these bones live? Once Ezekiel submitted to God's sovereignty, God was able to help Ezekiel start the process of rebuilding. And rebuilding all starts with remembering that God is the only one that can resurrect the ruins. He said, I will put breath in you and you shall come to life. I will attach the tendons to you and make flesh come upon you. Then you will know that I am the Lord. So after you've prayed, fireproof your foundation by speaking the word of God over it so that it can withstand any attack. And then soundproof your structure so that you can quiet the negative comments of your hater. Let there be peace and purpose as you focus on rebuilding something new and improve. Come on, let's pray. Father, thank you so much for providing everything we need to rebuild the ruins in our lives, whether it be our family, our careers, our attitudes, our mindsets, the way we think, our finances. God, you equip us with everything we need to start all over again. We are anointed to rebuild. We especially need your presence and your power. God, reveal every ruined area in our lives so that we can submit it to you and start rebuilding and bring glory to your name. We give you all the glory and honor, and it's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. Well, I pray that this talk has really blessed you today. I want you to remember that nothing is ever wasted when it comes to God. He is the resurrection and the life. So release it all to him. Now, I'm always here if you need me. Just call me. My number is right there. I would love to talk with you. But in the meantime, join me next week right here on this couch. And we're going to talk some more. God bless you.